Hello, I wish to record a brief video explaining how Moebius transformation traditionally appear in the theory of projective transformation, projective real line. So initially I come back to the content of main lectures. So in the second lecture we derived Moebius action of SL2R on the real line in the following way, as we did for general construction for any group G and some not necessarily normal subgroup H. For topological reasons, subgroup H shall be closed. So in our situation, G was SL2R, and subgroup H was taken as a group of lower triangular matrices. So such lower triangular matrices are parameterized by a positive real A, which they define diagonal elements, and C is the just real number. So such collection of matrices is parameterized by two parameters. SL2R is three-dimensional, so homogeneous space which we obtain shall have just one real parameter, so it's a set subset of a real line in some sense. So using such a parameter we may identify, it's easy to verify what equivalence classes in cosets can be parameterized by a real number which is just a fraction of elements in the second row. So just to the structure of our lower triangular matrices, we have a ratio B over D which define completely and uniquely element cosets of element under such equivalence relation. When embedding of a real line, real parameters into SL2R is defined through the section S, which send a real number U to the upper triangular matrix of this form. So when according to the explicit formula for the group action, which is completely defined as soon as we choose section S and we have natural projection P, when left multiplication by group element of G, everything can be just substitute into this formula, and result of calculation will be exactly linear fractional or Moebius transformation as it given here. So that is was construction defined on used in our lectures, but traditionally Moebius transformation are obtained in a different way. So here is a presentation of this main form of more traditional form for Moebius transformation. So we will start from the concept of homogeneous coordinates. Let us notice what if we have a linear transformation on a two-dimensional vector space. By the way, that construction work as well for any n-dimensional real vector space or complex vector space, but we just here interested in two-dimensional version, so I am keeping things as simple as possible. So we have two-dimensional vectors and we introduce the equivalence relation given just by scalar multiplication with non-zero parameter lambda to this two-dimensional vector. So all vectors proportional will be equivalent. So that is naturally represented if we have the R2. And when we have some point x, y on this plane, then this point x, y will be just equivalent to any point with the proportional coordinate. So we will have such a straight line passing through point x, y, which is a so all equivalent points belong to such straight line. And any of point on this belonging to such a straight line represent one particular coset. But having a lot of representative is not very practical, and we may wish to have one canonical representative, and if a second coordinate is different from zero, we can simply divide through it through by x2, and then point x1, x2 is represented by coordinates x1 divided by x2 and 1 in second coordinate. That has very clear geometrical interpretation. So we draw a line through horizontal line through point 1. So instead of xy, we have this intersection point on horizontal line, which has coordinates x divided by y 1, so on the same straight line. So that horizontal line represent almost every coset which we have here, any straight line, because it's intersect with horizontal line except the axis. Axis here the parallel and of course does not intersect horizontal line, and then that axis is representative for the point infinity. So in homogeneous coordinates that will be 1, 0. So that is representative of infinity, and so projective real line in a sense would be a union of the ordinary real line. So points of ordinary real line can be have projective coordinates in this way, and the one additional exceptional point infinity. That point infinity is added just because it's again in the sense of that previous transformation, it will be representative of something like 1 divided by 0. So whenever we have a need to do that exceptional operation, we may just use corresponding representative which make unnecessary to perform actual division. So, and of course there is even better picture, maybe rather than take representatives on the horizontal line here, we just put a unit circle, not unit circle, circle with diameter 1. So, and then for such a circle with diameter 1, we have again intersection point with any line, this time with any line including a horizontal one. So intersection point with horizontal line is this one, which represent the infinity. So this is so-called stereographic projection. So that is second double point of intersection here. So that is stereographic projection, which identify projective real line with the circle. Now, having this projective coordinate and projective real line, we can move to consideration of Moebius transformation. So having element of SL to R, that is 2 times 2 matrix, we of course have usual linear action in two-dimensional vector space by means of matrix multiplication. So if we multiply row times column, we will get such a result. And because that is again linear transformation, then corresponding linear action on R2 can be factored out through the corresponding action of projective real line, one-dimensional one. And in fact, that will be morphism in topological sense, topology preserved by that transformation. And using just a previous word about projective coordinates, we notice what a point x on the real line represented by a homogeneous coordinate x1 will be mapped to a point with homogeneous coordinate ax plus b and second coordinate cx plus d, and whenever cx plus d is different from zero, we can divide through homogeneous coordinates and obtain fractional linear transformation of the form which we already obtained before. So that is fractional linear form of Moebius transformation, rather useful and suggestive, but of course it has exceptional point if denominator here is equal to zero, division is not possible, and take possibility what we are considering a composition of several Moebius transformation, then correspondingly we need to take care about exceptional point for each transformation and composition, and it would become rather laborious. And sometimes, on the other hand, if you will work with projective coordinates, there is no problem with division by zero, but you need to care out all that elements together, that separately, numerator and denominator in that linear fractional transformation separately represent homogeneous coordinate on the projective line, and we need to keep two real numbers instead of one real number which represented by such a fraction. So that is also not very practical, and in most cases people stick with that linear fractional form with fraction, and just somehow that exceptional points are not discussed because it's known what by means of homogeneous coordinate we may treat them properly, and so for this reason we may just safely use that notation, which is not completely mathematically accurate absolutely for all values of axis. This is how the traditional Moebius transformation appears in the context of